Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Dr. Serge Valcott, Ordained Minister, member of the International Metaphysical Ministry, and I am hosting this show for you every Sunday to help you awaken your spiritual consciousness. Today, we're going to talk about mental prison. It is very important.
One day
and I'll be back.
Jesus, I'm only human, I'm just a woman, help me believe in what I could be, and all that I am, show me the stairway. One day at a time. One day at a time, sweet Jesus. That's all I'm asking from you. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus. And tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today. Show me the way, one day at a time.
Let me take this opportunity to thank you, all of you, for sharing my messages to the social media. I thank you for the time, for your time to listen to my messages. Although my messages may be different from many others, but remember, not everybody accepts to tell you the truth. I am here to help you because the show is spiritual conscious awareness. Therefore, we have no other choice than helping you awaken your spiritual consciousness. Today, we're going to talk about mental prison. Because many people could manage their life better mentally. What about if you don't know? If you don't know, and those who pretend to know let you in ignorance, you are in total darkness. Is it your fault? No, because you don't know. I was sent to help you discover what others haven't told you. I believe that if you were more sensitive, you would realize that your actions hurt the psychic atmosphere more. When I say your action, your psychic, your mental action hurt the psychic atmosphere more than your physical action. Because in the real world, in the physical world, people always complain about the smoke and fume from factories, from cars, but they ignore the impacts of our actions on the psychic level, and no one helps to better the situation because people don't know. They just know what's going on in the physical world, ignoring that a lot of things we are doing may contaminate the psychic atmosphere also. The toxic emanation from negative thoughts and feelings of hate, jealousy, anger, or discontent poison the atmosphere, as whatever is from smoke, fume, from car, from company, poison the physical atmosphere. Remember that saying, as above, so below. That means not only our physical action present the atmosphere, but our mental actions do the same. It will help to know that unhealthy thoughts and feelings inside human produce smelling, suffocating smoke to poison us mentally. Every day, I heard people blame cars, blame factories. But those don't do that much to our health. Then what is from our thought, word, and action? Of course, we cannot measure the damage of our thought through the universe. We cannot measure the damage of our words to the universe. Therefore, many just ignore them. Remember, I am here to tell you the truth. I will tell you today that this, your action from the mental atmosphere, is very dangerous as your action to the physical atmosphere. Our thoughts regularly discharge negativities into the planet because we let our speech go unguarded with a tendency to criticize others. Many of us consider ourselves the salt of the earth. They never take a bit of time to meditate on who they are, what the world is, and what they can do to better the world. They don't care about this kind of thing because of ignorance. Remember that today, the planet is suffering from a lack of love and compassion because we misuse our time in criticizing others instead of applauding their success. Guys, many of us don't even care about you when you get success. If they could kill you because you get success, they would have done that. But they are always ready to criticize you when you get a failure. But at the same time, they enjoy your failure. Guys, the earth provides you with possibilities to develop our potential. But to do so, you must be conscious of your fraternal relationship and show love and compassion to one another. I know that most of us focus on material needs. They ignore that the earth also needs some attention for its wellness. Remember that the earth provides you with all you need. The earth is your, really your mother. That's why some people call it Mother Nature. You get anything you need from the earth, but you do your best also to destroy the planet the way you behave toward it. Remember, if a candle shares its flame with others, this action will not decrease its life. Happiness never decreases by being shared. You create happiness for humanity when you spread the love around you. If you lack to let go of suffering, misery, pain, and disease around the planet, you could do so by spreading positivity. We are the result of our thoughts. We become what we think. I always say, before drinking a cup of water, you must ensure it's potable. Now, I want to add that it will be the same for your thinking. Before focus on something or before saying something, you must always make sure your thought doesn't damage yourself or others. This is very important. We are the result of our thoughts. We become what we think. Before drinking a cup of water, you ensure it's potable. By the same token, you should do the same for your thinking or your talking. Before you think, before you focus your thought on something, or before you let your mouth, you let a word out of your mouth, you should make sure it doesn't damage yourself and others. Guys, during your journey, you will have to interact with others constantly. Remember that interaction requires exchange between your inner and your outer worlds. The possibility of poisoning yourself and others is very high because of your interaction between yourself and others. Therefore, it will help if you made mental cleansing to boost your divine connection. If you're driving a car, don't you have to change oil every 3 months or whatever, depend on the a model and the mark of the car. But most of them, you have to change oil every 3 months. You cannot just keep debris inside of you. You have to do mental cleansing frequently in order to boost your divine connection. Remember that those who give priority to the outer world at the end are always disappointed. They should never rely on what comes from outside. Hypocrisy, jealousy, envy, and poor guidance permit external exchanges. If your goal is seeking happiness, joy, tranquility, peace, and love, you will only find them internally, not externally. Therefore, instead of trusting the outer world, you should make inner cleansing priority, because your values come from inside. You don't get values from outside. You get values from inside. Give priority to what's going on internally before your mental prisoning the psychic atmosphere. You will rather cleansing, or you will rather do internal cleansing frequently. This is very important. If a thorn pierces you, you can remove it forever with a needle. But to get rid of internal attitudes, you must see the mistaken beliefs which give rise to them. Then let love blossom to release them. Let me repeat that again. If a thorn hurts you, you can remove it forever just with a needle. But to get rid of internal attitudes, you must see the mistaken beliefs which give rise to them. Then you let love blossom to release them. Guys, word attitudes are due to a lack of love and compassion. Sharing love is the only remedy for this disease to stop invading your mind. Yeah, there are some kinds of attitudes that are very bad to you and to others. This is a good reason for you to share love, because love is the only remedy to stop this kind of disease when they invade your minds. Each needs to develop a pattern to spread love continually throughout the planet. Yeah, we must do that. We must develop some pattern to spread love continually throughout the planet. Yes. Do like the sun. The sun shares its love unconditionally by bombarding the universe daily with its rays. It's rays of love to make life possible on the planet. You should prepare your mind to do the same, showing compassion to one another continually. Remember that love is the ultimate purpose of life, isn't it? I believe so. Love is the ultimate purpose of life. Therefore, it will help the planet if you could become lovers by cleansing all the dust within. Very important. It's very important for you to cleanse regularly all the dust within. You're going to say, oh, this guy is talking about dust within. I have never seen dust within. Remember, your thoughts are a source of dust. When you think something wrong about somebody, it is dust. When you say something wrong about somebody, it is dust. When you do bad actions, it is dust, isn't it? When you let out bad words towards somebody, toward the planet, it is dust. You have to cleanse internally, regularly. Please make a habit of inviting love to dwell. Invite love to dwell within you. Once you clean up yourself, you will attract similar energy externally. Otherwise, you spread the mental poison. One thing you have to avoid doing during your journey, avoid to spread negative thought, avoid to spread negative word, avoid to spread negative action, avoid to do that. Be part of the light, the divine light. Be part of it. It is easy to be part of the divine light by cleansing yourself regularly. It is easy to be part of the divine light by loving, by sharing the love, sharing compassion to each other. This is all you have to do. This is all you have to do if you want to get rid of any mental prison that could come from you. Be part of the light. Be part of the divine light. And avoid poisoning the atmosphere. Thank you, thank you, thank you to all of you. And I specially thank you for sharing my message, sharing it through the social media, sharing it to your friends, to your contact. Thank you so much. My name again is Dr. Serge Valco, and I'm a doctor in the metaphysical science, an ordained minister, member of the International Metaphysical Ministry. Have a nice week.
Do you remember when you walked among men? Well, Jesus, you know, if you're looking below, it's worse now than then. Cheating been stealing. Violence and crime. So for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time. Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do. Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way. One day at a time.